What is up, my dudes? This is YardBrah, and you're tuning into another episode of My Lawn. All right. I've been looking, and I've just been just trolling on YouTube, just watching random vids, and I'm seeing a lot of people verticutting. Like, I have the Sunjoe Dethatcher, and I use the Tine cartridge, but I also have the blades for the verticutting. I'm curious. I've never done it. I always thought the verticutting was for like making grooves so you can overseed, and then the seeds have a little bed to rest in as they try to germinate. But apparently, if you have, you know, low cut real mowing and your grass is getting thick, you gotta let it breathe. I like that concept. So we're gonna try it today. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely good. It's definitely a good thing to do. If you are, I mean, even in general, it's just a good thing to do. You know what I mean? Like, you can see, like, things are coming up. I was surprised anything came up because I just, you know, seeded this. We just overseeded in the spring. It looks decent. And I'm just thinking, man, there should be nothing here. But look at that. A good amount of stuff came up, and then we're gonna mow it and it's gonna be healthy. Now, I'm a little scared of the Fenceline side strips, not gonna lie. I have not dethatched this area for about, I would have to say a year. I'm a little scared because there's a lot of moss here. Let's check it out. Kidding me right now, guys. Look at what has developed on the fence line side strips. This is 600 square feet of action right now. 600 square feet with all that nastiness. Now to me, I'm a little confused because to me this looks like I'm dethatching. Right? It's not, I mean, is it the same concept? Like when I use the tines, it does destroy a lot. This isn't really destroying. It's not even like raking really. It really is vertical cutting. I like it. I've never used it. And this is on the middle setting, by the way. This is on the, I don't know if you guys saw that. Middle setting. Oh my gosh. I like verticutting. It is kind of fun. Now, after I'm just used to, you know, dethatching and then seeding. Okay, let me take a break. 1 second. Guys, I told you I was gonna cut to half an inch. And subconsciously, I wanted to overseed. Yeah, I'm gonna cut to half an inch, and then just let it grow with some fertilizer. No, I wanted to freaking overseed. I'm not gonna lie. I've been staring at this poa annua. I've been staring at this lawn that just looks super uneven, and I'm over it. Here's the thing too. I need more products and I'm running out of room. So I gotta get rid of this seed. I gotta get rid of this peat moss. I gotta get rid of some of this soil that's left over. Yes, I know I sand leveled. Oh my gosh, why are you putting soil on top? Well, it's kind of like putting compost on top. It's the same stuff. And we're gonna sand level in the fall anyways. And we're gonna do a full on renovation. So might as well get our exercise and practice in, right? Yeah. Here's the entire process one more time in the front. This is the brand new bag of Baron Brugg Turf Blue Pro Kentucky Bluegrass that I had from last season. Now, last season, the grass to me, it was nice, but it was definitely lighter in color. This Turf Blue Pro is not a dark cultivar. I don't remember how much I spent in this bag. I'm pretty sure I spent a lot of money in this bag. So we're gonna plant that in. So it's just gonna be an addition to the salad bar. I don't know if the perennial rye is gonna pop through again and, you know, help that darkness with this, but apparently the Baron Brugg Turf Blue Pro with this yellow jacket, right? This yellow jacket technology germinates 7 to 10 days. Max, they said 21 days. And usually, for me, I've noticed Kentucky bluegrass takes like 30 days to germinate. 30! Gosh, so I was definitely gonna overseed in the back too, but then what kind of content am I gonna have if I do that? I need the backyard right now, so I'm gonna chill in the backyard. I'm not gonna, you know, even if I verticut back there, I'm not gonna oversee. Don't worry, I'm gonna have content. I'm still gonna be out there every day. Remember, we have the sidewalk strips, we have the neighbor patches I'm not doing anything with. Well, kind of. The neighbor patches, you'll see. But here is the process one more time, just in case you don't remember it. I know you guys remember. You could probably say the entire process right now in front of everyone. You know the process. Here you go. Here it is. Spread the rest of this before a break. I told you I'm crazy. I'm a crazy person. And that's probably why you guys watch me. Because I'm a nutcase. I don't have any soil. I don't want to go to the store right now. Break. It's times like these where I enjoy a small lawn. One of you want the update in the back. It's not good. There you go, buddy. What do you think? Yep.
No buen buen.
If this could just work, that'd be great. Please work. Please work. I do not want to hand do this today. I forgot I bought a bunch of starter for peat moss and freaking broadcast spreader.
I don't know why I'm obsessed with the process. I don't know why. Okay, here's why I did this. The temperatures in the next, last week we got up to 90. That was insane. But our temperatures here, I'm telling you right now, it's like spring. It's like spring. For sure. At night, 50s. During the day, 60s. It's good. I mean, we have, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In the next 10 days, say this stuff germinates, it's not going to be any hot. I think the highest is like 76. Come on. Come on. This is definitely time to overseed. In the Pacific Northwest, 100%. Nothing's gonna cook. Nothing's cooking. This is the perfect time. I'm pretty sure our summer is gonna be like late August, September. We're gonna get some hotness, and then it's gonna be just super cold. We'll probably have 2 weeks of hotness, and then it's gonna be freezing. And then, boom, reno time. So, yeah, I'm impatient. Yeah, the lawn was looking okay on camera from afar, okay. But when you're the owner of this lawn and you look at it, it's frustrating to look at all the different colors from the Poa trivialis, the Poa annua. It was just killing me. And then here's what pisses me off. Some stupid freaking neighbor is letting their dog just shit all over the freaking lawn. Yeah, this is what I bought. This is what I bought right here. If this doesn't work, you know what I'm gonna do? I hate to do this, but I'm gonna wire some like infrared. So if you step into my lawn and the sensor's on, there's gonna be the loudest freaking alarm on earth. It's gonna be awesome. I'm just kidding, that's probably illegal, I don't know. But I just wanna make sure that the dogs just don't come in here. There was a pee spot. I don't know why I'm not documenting this stuff. You know why? It's because when I get out there and I see the pee spots, or if I see a freaking poop, I get pissed. I'm just like so like frustrated and irritated. Like, who the F is doing this? What disrespectful mother trucker is letting their dog just shit on my yard and piss in my yard? Yeah, I get frustrated. And then I go have a coffee, and then I'm fine. And then I just laugh about it. And I'm like, you know what? Screw it. It's time to overseed. Screw it. I can't wait any longer. Here you go.
I'm pretty sure this is how you use a broadcast spreader. Hold it. You never seen it like this before.
This is my craziness. This is my madness. I'm sure this is why you guys follow me, because I just do the craziest things, and I'm very, like, spontaneous. It's like, I'm bored today. Let's overseed. What materials do we have on deck? Let's overseed. It's a good workout, I'm not gonna lie. That is a hefty workout. Like, I just got done showering and I'm just like, that was a good workout. I burned a ton of calories. I may have put those calories back in with some unhealthy food. But we burnt the calories and we're out there having fun. Guys, I got a bunch of stuff to do. I got a bunch more stuff to do.
I saw this once on YouTube.
I have some maintenance I have to do on some tools. I got the backyard to make amazing. I have a lot of stuff. Stay tuned. You guys are amazing. Guys, I really appreciate you. Like, look at all the views. I mean, We're killing the views in a couple hours. I'm just like, I'm so impressed with you all. I just really, really appreciate you guys. I thank you so much. You're amazing. This is so fun. And this is why I keep going every single day, because I'm like excited for you guys to see stuff in my lawn. You're the best. We'll catch you in the next video. Take it easy.